107.8. Drive Time. Brought to you by Bowers and Pitsea Football Club. This is Gateway 97.8 for Basildon and East Thurrock.
Just after 5 o'clock, welcome to the Friday Drive with Rolson, brought to you by Bowers and Pitsea Football Club. I do hope that you're well and that you're going to stay listening, because coming up in this hour, we've got to talk about a new mural that apparently has been painted in Basildon. We're going to find out more about that in a few minutes' time, because I'm going to be linking up with Lady Sidra Naeem, one of my regular guests on the Drive Time show. Also, I want to have a little bit of a frank and open discussion about Afghanistan as well, because we know that is affecting an awful lot of Muslims at the moment. Really heartbreaking stories coming out of the country. So we'll chat with her, talking about a new mural that apparently has been painted today. I've been missing it. I've not been getting out and about as much as I should do. But one person who was there this morning, who's going to enlighten you and I, dear listener, right now, is Lady Sidra Naeem, who joins me via the power of social interfacing, or whatever it is that they call it. Lady Sidra, all the way over there in Brentwood. Good evening to you. How are you? And how did it go this morning?
Yes, I'm very well, thank you. And yes, it went very well. So it's actually Peoples and Places, a big arts project, which is running in Basildon at the moment to liven up the town. And a woman together were very lucky, the group which I run, which was chosen to actually design a mural to show equality and diversity in Basildon. So there was a huge wall to fill up, and we had a few women together sessions where each woman made a little piece of that mural, which was then put together and made into this lovely grand design, which is on display for the public to see, for Basildon and beyond. Absolutely.
What does it display? What does it display?
So it shows women sharing food, because it had to show women together. It says the word women together on it. There's women of four different faith backgrounds, colours, creed, status, everybody there. And they're all sort of together, and they're all sharing food with one another. And there's other aspects of women together depicted in that picture. That's really, really great. And it just gave the women so much confidence to know that we own a little piece of that mural, which is out there for everybody to see. And then not only that, then we helped to paint it. So we were painting away this morning, and there was a little bit of art therapy there. It was therapeutic. We were showing ownership of that mural. It increased the ladies' confidence and self-esteem, and just made us feel so good, really. And we feel really part of Basildon now as well. So, yeah.
And where can we see the mural? Where can we see it?
Right. You'll be able to see it in the town centre. So if you go to the shopping centre, right, there are murals everywhere, all over the shopping centre. There's, I think, approximately, I would say, 6 altogether, and we are near Costa Coffee.
Right. Oh, yeah, I know. Okay. Yes. I'll have to have a walk out that way and have a look and take some pickies of it. So it's a good feeling then for the women, who I know some of them suffer quite a bit of hardship, and it brings them together. That's what you aim to do, isn't it?
That's right. And it was filmed as well. So we had a film is being made now as I speak. We had the cameramen today. So they interviewed me as well, and I will be releasing that film soon as everything is completed, because the mural is not complete yet. We go again on Tuesday to finish off some flowers and things, which was another thing on there, is some flowers which we need to fill in, paint. We couldn't finish it all in one day, so we will be back there on Tuesday, and then after that the film will be released once the whole mural is complete. And that will go on my YouTube channel and all over social media, so everybody will be able to then see.
We'll share it on our Gateway social media as well. It'd be nice to do that for you.
Yes, and the new back Gateway as well, because I mentioned I'm going there later, and they said, yes, that's really great. And wonderful. And
I expect some of the ladies are listening to you probably now on their radio or on their smart speakers. We've got to talk about another topic, which I know that you're going to have something to say about, Afghanistan. It's a very sad situation there at the moment. A lot of people being displaced, a lot of people displacing themselves, obviously, because they don't like the new regime. The Taliban they've been sort of out of power really for 20 years. A lot of the alliance forces have left the country. Lady Sidra, was that the right thing for them to do?
You know what, this is a very complicated scenario altogether. So the people have left are looking at the previous Taliban, you know, when they ruled the land, and they were definitely not practicing their religion. They were making up the religion as they go along, picking and choosing bits to suit themselves. It was all about land, power, and money. Okay, so based on that, these refugees are leaving the country. This new Taliban now that are coming into power, they're promising different things, but we all know that once politicians do get into power, they do, once they're in power, they change their minds. It's all sometimes, isn't it, a way of getting the votes and all the rest, or winning the hearts of people. So until it happens, we don't really know what's going to happen. They have said that then they're going to treat women better. They're going to stop the drugs. So those are two good things that I can see in there. All the narcotics will all stop and all of that kind of stuff. But that wasn't in the religion in the first place. So this Sharia law business that before they showed to the whole world was not really Sharia law, because oppressing women is not in the religion. Drugs and all of this other stuff is not in the religion anyway. Stopping women driving is not in the religion. So if they followed Sharia law properly and went by the proper laws, there wouldn't be a problem. And the other really important thing is that you're not allowed to force people. Religion is religion, but there is no compulsion in religion. So they can say this is what the religion says, but you can't force people and certainly not kill them. You're not allowed to kill people. So, you know, I think time will tell a little bit more now on what is going to happen.
The word Taliban is a frightening word, we know, to a lot of people. And as you say, it's a different Taliban, but they do walk around Lady Sidra with guns. I know that frightens a lot of people. But we must also remember that the government there that we've helped keep in power, and we've also supplied arms and helicopters and various things to, and try to help them manage their own country. I'm hearing reports of corruption, that the leaders have left the country. They've taken stacks of money with them as well, kitted themselves out with lots of a fleet of Range Rover Discoveries. They're now in hiding in the United Arab Emirates. No government seems out in the Middle East seems to be completely free of corruption. Do you think that that is another reason that the Taliban has seized power like it has done?
Yes, I think there is unfortunately a lot of corruption, but the laws are not there in the first place. So if we look at England or America, really good political laws are there. So if things like this happen, you know, you go to prison if it happened in England, or there's penalties. The police are very strong. The problem with some of these countries where it's generally a poverty-stricken country, bribery comes into play a lot, unfortunately. So when people do bad, you just have to give the money some police and then you're out of trouble, basically, you know? So the political laws are not strong enough, really. And that's what then causes all the corruption and the problems. And the leaders who do come into power in these countries, they're completely in the lead of even the laws. Everything is down then to the government. There's no police, you know, everything's under them. So basically they can do what they please, and that's where the corruption is, unfortunately.
Should we be negotiating with the Taliban? Should we sort of sit and watch and see what's happening over the next few weeks, let things settle down a bit? And then they are saying they want to trade with people, they want to have good negotiations with diplomats from other countries, although we've seen lots of the embassies there, the British and the American ones, being evacuated. If they want to have a good relationship, we need the embassies there, don't we?
Yes, we do. And I think, personally feel, let's wait and see. Let's see, do they stick to their word? Are they going to do all those things that they've promised? Because according to the things they've promised, things seem to be okay. But if they don't, then obviously the world is going to have to get involved again, because it's not going to, we're not going to tolerate terrorism. Muslims will stand up for that, because we don't believe in any of those bad things. It is not Islam. Islam does not dictate to go around killing people, you know, for no reason, and killing others, and also killing people just because they're not following their religion. It's up to each individual person what they want to do. You are liable for your own deeds, and we believe we have to answer to God in the end.
So, well, I don't know much about Sharia law, Lady Sidra, but we now are in a situation here in the UK. Prime Minister Boris Johnson has said 20,000 Afghan refugees are going to be accommodated here in the UK. They're going to be absorbed right across the country. We can see perhaps some of those arriving in Basildon at some stage or another. So perhaps we might see some more people for your women's group even here. I wonder how it's going to affect things locally.
I think that there will need to be resources in place. For example, I doubt it very much if those people will be able to speak English fluently. We don't know that. They may be able to, I don't know. Depends on their education. So more English classes for them, more support generally with other Muslims to strengthen them. Some of them may have seen lots of trauma, wars and things. And the women, they will definitely need to be strengthened. They need to come to Women Together. We will strengthen them, because we don't know what kind of oppression they've faced. And also education on their religion themselves, because who knows what kind of distorted part of the religion they've been learning out there. We don't know that. Because the religion does not say any of those things that they may have experienced. So they will need, awareness, if you like, of the religion as well.
Well, they can come and see your mural in the town centre, or a series of murals that you've painted today. And, finally, Lady Sidra, you know, is there anything you think more that the government can do to help Afghanistan at the moment?
I think the government are actually doing really well. I really do, because it's not easy, really, for a country to welcome refugees, thousands in their thousands, from another country, especially a country which is very, very different to our own. I think the government are doing very well in America and in England to welcome them. It costs money, does it not, to incorporate, you know, refugees into your country, and then give them housing and homes and all the rest. So I think at the moment they're doing very well, and we will have to see, I think, once the refugees get here, what their needs are. But the needs that I can think of will be English speaking skills, schooling to understand what kind of background they are from, the children, because they will be from very different backgrounds to our own here. And just tolerate, you know, we need to tolerate them. And again, equality and diversity comes in big time, doesn't it, really? We have to understand them. They're from different backgrounds, different faith, different colour, completely different way of upbringing to England. I mean, they will be frightened as well.
Yeah. The trauma that they've been through. Absolutely. And the trauma that they've been through already. And, you know, we want to see them not have any further trauma when they come to the UK. Lady Sidra Naeem, that's where we have to leave it, only for time reasons. But I want to say have a great weekend. Good luck with the painting next week. And we'll touch base with you again very soon, right here on our local radio. It's Gateway 97.8.
Thank you very much. Thank you.